My name is Tama. I'm from Indonesia. I live in Yogyakarta. It's a province in Indonesia. And then I've been working before this. I work for an LGBTI organization in Yogyakarta called People Like Us Satu Hati. Been working there for 3 years, but I'm also active in Arus Pelangi. It's a national LGBTI organization in Indonesia. But basically, like my daily life, I work mostly for transgender issue, especially trans men. So actually, I grew up in another part of Java, Indonesia. So I moved to Yogyakarta to study in university. But then in 2008, I got problem because my parents found out that I'm a trans man. Transgender man, and then I got kicked out from house. But then there are a lot of friends helping me back then. They are almost all of them are LGBTI activists. So I think what they are doing are great, and then I don't want that kind of works stop. So I decided to continue. After I volunteer in LGBTI organization for a while, still in People Like Us Satu Hati, but I found difficulties in finding information about transgender men. So in around 2012, 2013, I decided to not just waiting for them to give me information, but like to take a more active role in the movement by providing the information about transgender men. And then also I believe that if I want LGBTI movement to talk more about transgender people in Indonesia, then I have to take more active role again. So I decided to be the chairperson of this LGBTI organization. Becoming LGBTI person in Indonesia, it's not easy. I cannot say that we are criminalized yet for now, but you know, like 9 of 10 LGBTI person are facing a daily basis discrimination and stigma and also violence. So it's like 90% of us. It's a huge number. And then, like for example, being kicked out from house from in our very young age is very common in Indonesia, especially when you are transgender, especially transgender woman. Also being bullied in school without any access to help is also it's also a daily life of LGBTI people. So the discrimination and violence is really about daily rights, basic rights. And it's so difficult to get support or to push the government to protect us. So basically, we have to, you know, we have to depend on each other in terms of surviving. So in 2016, the situation of LGBTI getting worse. It got worse because of in the beginning of the year, our minister of high education and research, he said like LGBTI are not supposed to be in schools and universities. So this hate speech led to other hate speech made by high officials. So it also like encouraged people to do violence to LGBTI. I mean, like, violence were always there, but it was increasing a lot. In Yogyakarta, I can say Yogyakarta is one of the province that get the most horrible effect. During 2016, there were 9 attacks to events held by LGBTI organization. So it's terrible. That's it. It's like also, for example, our office got attacked as well. So they were looking for us, not only our events, but the organization. They were targeting the organization. That was the worst year of our life. The worst thing is also that in the second half year of 2016, this Islamic fundamentalist group, they also try to criminalize us through the judicial review in constitutional court. So it's like we get attacked everywhere. Yeah, basically those shit makes me in some point I wanted to stop, especially when I knew that my parents or my family share the same situation with me. They got some threats as well. I was thinking about stopping, but my family are so, they are so supportive. They didn't ask me to stop. So now I don't want to stop. I think like this is the right way. We have to do this. Yeah. I'm not sure. Actually, because I live far away from my family, but I think in my parents' context, when they realize that I'm working as I'm active as an LGBTI activist, they realize that it's full of risk. So for my parents, it would be better to support me so that they can see me alive, rather than arguing about my identity. Doesn't matter anymore. Like, they want to see me alive. That's it. The future of LGBTI people in Indonesia, I believe we will get better. But before that, we need to face like dark age, criminalization, worsening violence towards LGBTI people, LGBTI organization, LGBTI human rights defender. We have to go through that. But then I have to appreciate like every small victory that we have achieved. It's those kind of victories show that what we are doing is right, that we accomplish things and we will accomplish more.
Kalau satu dari tiga perempuan mengalami kekerasan, kawan-kawan harus tahu bahwa satu dari dua teman-teman LGBT di Indonesia mengalami kekerasan seksual. 89.3% mengalami kekerasan setiap harinya. Itu jumlahnya adalah 9 dari 10. Hampir semua dari kami mengalami kekerasan dan setengahnya adalah kekerasan seksual. Saya di sini berdiri bersama kawan-kawan lain untuk menghentikan kekerasan pada siapapun, pada ibu kami, pada saudara kami, pada kawan-kawan kami, pada kawan-kawan lesbian yang lebih rentan mengalami kekerasan seksual dan pernikahan paksa, pada kawan-kawan transgender perempuan yang lebih rentan mengalami kekerasan seksual di jalanan, yang ketika mereka ditangani oleh dinas sosial mereka juga mendapatkan pelecehan. Kami dan saya percaya teman-teman di sini akan terus berdiri bersama-sama dari tahun ke tahun sampai kekerasan seksual dihapuskan.